really interested. The budget cuts are happening. This is our speak out today to defend education. Everyone is welcome to come and say something. So please, I urge you, come down from the second, third, fourth, fifth floor. Plenty of seats in the front row. Talk to Betty, he'll put you on the list. And we'll have Joe in the next room.
Hi, I'm Joe Doyle. I'm
Joe.
A union rep for the faculty here at the school. From the union, on your side, we're fighting for your education. These budget cuts are cutting pretty deep. They're hurting in ways that you don't even see. I'm the chair of a department, and recently I went through our catalog. And I was stunned by the number of classes that we created, wrote up, got approved, are in the catalog, and are not offered. Classes that 5 years ago, I designed 5 years ago, have never been offered and are now obsolete. That you need for a good education. With the loss of a D, with not enough faculty, I don't even have the time to redesign the class being offered or not. So the education you get are getting that used to be class A is down a little bit. All right, not quite what it should be. And we need you, and you need to be fully educated. We need an educated workforce. And we need it, you know, we need your civil services. We need you to be good citizens. So fight the cuts, fight back, and realize it's nibbling at you everywhere, even behind the scenes when I can't design a class, when I can't offer new material, when the administration says, no, Joe, we're not going to offer any more classes. We're going to cut back some of the ones we already have, and we're certainly not going to do any new ones. Although you need those new classes, it's important. Education is a struggle, okay? I know I'm speaking to the choir. You all know this, okay? Talk to your friends. Try to enlighten your friends. Get them to understand that they have to participate in the educational process by fighting the cuts. They have to take responsibility for their education. This is a crucial time in American history. We need an educated workforce for any number of reasons, or we're going to lose our democracy. He said we're going to wind up working on the plantation. We spoke true words. They're trying to turn us into serfs. They're trying to turn us into wage slaves, or less than wage slaves. Okay. Take care.
Everybody keep it at 2 minutes. Get that line going here. Come on, Mark, you're next. Oh, Brenda's next. All right. Anyway, how's everybody doing?
Good.
For me, trying to pay rent, we're trying to find a place with my budget because I can't get help in the financial aid. I am renting a couch or a chair in a crack house. Talk about secondhand smoke. And then coming here and trying to do what I'm doing. So if I can survive in a crack house, you guys, instead of being out on the street, we all need help. We all need to support each other. If you need help on tutoring or a hug or food or whatever, you get it from your fellow students, from your staff. They're... We're losing more and more teachers, more and more staff that promised and I depended on, and they're gone. But I'm still here, and there's still a few people here. So anyway, we got to stick together and fight.
Thank you, DC. I'll keep this real short. I'm Brenda Johnson with the Student Services here at BCC. Nice to see all of you here today. I wish we had twice as many. I want to tell you from an administrative point of view just how bad it is. It is absolutely appalling that our colleges have to exist on the budget we currently have. They have been cut tremendously. Every program, not just financial aid, EOPS, anything. Staff, key staff, laid off. And it doesn't even matter if it was a one office person. If they're laid off, we don't even have anyone to replace them. And it's only getting worse. Your voice matters. It breaks my heart for those students, for example, who registered late attempted to register late this past summer for fall. They are in their classes, and guess what? It's only going to get worse. It's only going to get worse. So we need you to be strong, to fight, to march, to speak out, to be well informed. It makes a difference. Thank you.
I wrote this on the story. My concern, my fears, is our lack of concern. The effort we take is showing no effort at all. How we adorn ourselves for a place beside you is not valuable. Each person here has committed themselves to an ideal established without our consent. And still we adhere. Ask yourselves, why are we here? Why do we come? What is it you believe? Is it to be discouraged or sabotaged? Maybe to be lied to and robbed. If so, cast your mind. Enjoy ignorance and embrace the myth that your local, state, and federal government support your endeavor to better yourself. Don't ask questions, why are so many people in this class and why does a school at this level cost so much? Why is it that a government that claims they encourage me to be here continue to saddle me with debt? Why is more and more taken from this establishment and others like it? Why are more and more less concerned? This is not about those up here or those who speak. If you thought that, you were wrong. If you think these problems will fix themselves, you are also wrong. And if you think I'm up here to reprimand anyone, once more, you are wrong. My goal is to implore you to subscribe to a different pattern of thought, to tell the least of you that you matter, that you count, and encourage those of you who are grieved with this cause for alarm to continue to press on because your efforts don't go unnoticed. Heighten your awareness. Acknowledge the role that you can and must play to preserve our education system, to raise its quality, and to protect what it is our education system provides for us. A better community, a better future, and a better you. Thank you.
Things. I want to talk about March 4th, what it was and what it wasn't, because I think we make a really big mistake if we think it didn't make a difference. March 4th was the first time that education in California got together and had one united action from kindergarten up through PhD. In the past, everybody's been divided and fighting against each other. And as a result of what we did, the CSUs are getting more money, the UCs are getting more money, the community colleges are getting cut less than they would have otherwise, and K-12 is getting screwed. Because the people at the top learn that it's a very bad thing when you attack everybody and everybody gets together and fights back.
Yes.
That's what happens. But we have to be smarter than that and understand that we still have to fight back, and we have to fight back together, and not just education, transportation, healthcare. Did you hear what Meg Whitman's commercial said? Cut welfare and fund education. What are we talking about here? This is insane. California is the ninth largest economy in the world. It's the home of every major corporation and bank. It has some of the richest people in the world on the top, 50 of Forbes and list of the richest people in the world. And someone is going to tell us there's no money? That's
That's what we're being told. There's no money. There is plenty of money in California. And let's not let the Democrats off the hook either, because they're just in the process today of passing a budget with no new taxes. And no new taxes means no new funding for education. I am sick and tired as a community college instructor of being told to do more for less. You cannot do more for less. You do less for less. Our carpets are being cleaned one less time a week because our custodial staff has been cut to the bone. This work of setting up chairs and setting up this mic today are extra work that they're not paid to do. We are cut to the bone. Our part-time instructors have been laid off. We have 100 less sections this year, 10% less sections than last year at DCC. That's why, as Brenda said, you can't get into a class. We have 10% less sections, but we only have 2.25% less students. Do the math. It means you're crammed into rooms and you might not even have a seat. This is disgraceful, and I agree with the last speaker. It is not going to fix itself, and the politicians in Sacramento are not going to fix it, and Obama and the politicians in Washington are not going to fix it. There's only one group of people who can fix it. You're sitting in front of me. Thanks.